Millennium was a TV show that ran from 1996 to 1999. The internet was just getting going, and the year 2000, or the new millennium, was only a few years away. The series follows the investigations of ex-FBI agent Frank Black, who has the ability to see inside the minds of criminals. He works for a mysterious organization known as the Millennium Group, and he mostly investigates serial killers. The first season was pretty dark for a television series for that time, and I just loved it. The next two seasons kind of went down a rabbit hole of conspiracies involving the Millennium Group that didn't make a whole lot of sense at times. It revolved around some apocalyptic event happening when the calendar year hit 2000. Frank and the group have most of their contact via computer, and his desktop has a Millennium logo of an Ouroboros with a countdown to show how many days until the new century. Throughout the three seasons, there was a subplot involving the devil and religion. The devil seems to have noticed Frank, maybe because of his abilities to get into the head of these really evil people. In the first season, there was a man who was stalking Frank, and he ends up kidnapping his wife. Frank finds him and stabs him, but he's still alive, so he continues to stab him, killing him. In the second season, while Frank is away on a case, the power goes out in his house, and his wife realizes someone has broken in. A detective who is Frank's friend shows up to search the home and is killed by the intruder, who seems to be some version of the devil or a demon. This is too much for his wife, and she leaves him, taking their daughter, saying she needs a break. Frank says that he won't live in that house until they are family again, so he rents a different home, leaving their house empty. And this is where the episode that I'm reviewing takes place. It's called The Curse of Frank Black. It happens on Halloween, and it opens with a quote. "Do you ever find yourself talking with the dead? Since Willie's death, I catch myself every day involuntarily talking with him as if he were with me. Abraham Lincoln, upon the death of his son." On Halloween night, Frank is getting ready to pick up his daughter in order to take her trick-or-treating. He carved out a pumpkin and tries to light it with the last match, but it blows out, so he's unable to light it. On the match pack is the number 268, and the price of the candle is $2.68. Just before leaving, he sees two trick-or-treaters wearing football jerseys that have the numbers 268 on them. He thinks he sees a devil across the street amongst the other trick-or-treaters, but it disappears. He leaves, and inside the house, the pumpkin is now lit. While out with his daughter, she stops at one house that has the number 268 and tells him that she doesn't want to go there because it's haunted. Frank tells her that there is no such things as ghosts, but is reminded of an event that happened as a child concerning that house. In a flashback, as a child, Frank is dared by his friends to knock on the door of that house on Halloween while trick-or-treating. They say it's rumored to be haunted, but he does it anyway. A man answers, not realizing that it's Halloween, and he invites Frank inside. The man tells him that he'll give Frank a treat if he can do a trick.
"You know why you're doing this, kid? No? You know what Halloween is all about? Halloween is believed to have been started by the ancient druids, who believed that on this evening, Saman, the lord of the dead, summoned evil spirits, and the devils and witches were free to roam the earth. And on this night, the spirits of the dead returned to visit past family and acquaintances from this life. So, kid, for your trick, I want you to tell me, is it true? Is it possible that the dead can return? Just for 5 minutes? Just to tell someone who had no idea that he'd never see him again that there's a better place than this and that they're waiting for him. Just for a minute. Is it true? Is it possible?"
"There's no such thing as ghosts. Can I have my treat now?"
After dropping his daughter off with his mother, while driving back home, his odometer hits 268 and his car breaks down. So he ends up walking home and sees some kids egging a house and he chases them off. It turns out to be his house, the one that no one is living in. He goes inside and overhears some teenagers in the basement try to scare each other with a ghost story of Frank and that detective's murder. Frank interrupts, scaring them off, and is again reminded of his past. Recalling his reaction as a teenager when the man in that house he had trick-or-treated at had committed suicide. Frank leaves that house frustrated at his current situation. When he gets back to his rental home, he can't get inside, so he has to climb through a window and is surprised to find the burning pumpkin. He looks through the mail and all the sports scores on the TV are a variation of 268. He realizes that the numbers 268 and the letters ACTS have been appearing to him throughout the day. Security shows up saying there was a report of a break-in. Frank explains that he'd locked himself out. As they leave, he sees ACTS on their coats and 268 on the license plate. He takes these coincidences to be pointing to him toward a Bible verse. Acts 26:8. Why should it be thought incredible by you that God raises the dead? Frank hears a noise coming from his attic and goes up there. He finds that man's ghost. He claims to have been sent to warn Frank that he should abandon his work with the Millennium Group and return to live with his wife and child.
I know you're feeling strange right now, kid, but believe me, it's a hell of a lot creepier for me to be back. That night, I was so dying to know if the dead can return, if there was anything afterwards. Remember? I'll tell you this. All that stuff you hear about the fire and the brimstone and the rats and the excrement and the demons tormenting you for all of eternity, there's none of that stuff. It's worse.
The man cautions Frank that he'll end up as a lonely outcast, just as he did.
You know, I threw things in my house too. Not eggs though, I think I threw dog crap. Yeah, I threw dog crap from my backyard at my kitchen window. I never cleaned it off. Take this deal, kid. Secure you and your family's future because the time is near and he will win. There's no way he can lose.
When will it happen?
He goes back downstairs and sees his computer blinking with a Millennium logo, which reads that there are 790 days remaining. So at this point, Frank's life is a mess. He could finally just give up and take to drinking or some other drug. He could join an online group that's there to take advantage of desperate and lonely people. He could rage against the machine and blame someone else. But Frank decides not to just give up the fight and realizes it's time to get his life back on track. It's morning and he returns to his old house with a bucket of soapy water and a sponge, then begins cleaning off the eggs. As he cleans, he sees the demonic figure from the day before, but he ignores it and continues his work. This is a pretty good story for the Halloween season. There's no gore or guys running around in masks killing people, although I like some of those. I find myself rewatching this every few years when October rolls around. And if you like ghost stories, this one's still a fun one to watch. Good night.
Boo.